So in this video, we're going to talk about L'Hopital's rule. And L'Hopital's rule is basically something to help calculate limits. And the idea is, you know, x is approaching something. It could be positive infinity. It could be negative infinity. It could be some finite number. The idea is maybe the top is going to infinity, positive or negative infinity. The same thing with the denominator. So you end up with the form, what's called the indeterminate form, infinity over infinity. Perhaps also the top is going to zero, and maybe the bottom is also going to zero. It says in that case what you can do is you can basically turn one limit problem into another limit problem by taking the derivative of the top and dividing that by the derivative of the bottom. Okay, and sometimes they'll put a little LH or H in between there to indicate that you're using L'Hopital's rule. Be careful too, because you're taking the derivative of the numerator all by itself. Same thing with the denominator. You're not using the quotient rule when you do the derivative. So let's do some examples here. The limit as x goes to 0 of sine of x over x. You may remember this one, but if you plug in 0, notice you get sine of 0, which is 0. You'll get 0 on the bottom, which is 0. That means I can use L'Hopital's rule on it. And I'll get the limit as x approaches 0. The derivative of sine is just cosine of x. And then the derivative of x is 1. And we basically repeat this process. We plug 0 in. Well, cosine of 0 is 1. And you're dividing by 1. And that is your answer in this case. And you may recall that the limit as x goes to 0 of sine x over x is in fact equal to 1. Let's do a few of these here. L'Hopital's rule is one of these things, too, that makes a lot of limit problems easier, but don't get carried away. You have to kind of pick and choose your battles. People will try to use L'Hopital's rule even when it's not applicable. So really make sure that you're getting either infinity over infinity or 0 over 0. Let's make it the limit as x goes to infinity of ln of x divided by x. As x goes to infinity, ln of x is infinity. Same thing with the bottom. So I'm getting the form infinity over infinity, which means I can use L'Hopital's rule again. So I'll have the limit as x approaches infinity. The derivative of x is just 1. The derivative of ln of x is 1 over x. And 1 over x divided by 1 is the same thing as 1 divided by x. Well, 1 over a large number is the same thing as having 0. So that'll be the answer to your limit. Let's do a slight variation on this problem. Let's make it the limit as x approaches 0 from the right of ln of x over x. Okay, so let's think about this now. Well, certainly as x approaches 0 from the right, the denominator is going to get close to 0. What happens to ln of x, though? Does that become 0? And again, this is where it's maybe useful to think about the graph of ln of x. Remember, ln of x looks like this, roughly. So it says as x approaches 0 from the right, ln of x actually goes down to negative infinity. So you're kind of getting the form negative infinity over 0, which is not one of the indeterminate forms, so you can't use L'Hopital's rule. The idea is, though, the numerator is getting big, but it's negative. The denominator is getting small, but it's positive. Well, if you take a big number and divide it by a small number, you still get a big number. The denominator, again, is positive. The numerator is negative. So your answer to this problem is actually just going to be negative infinity, and there's not a lot of work to do. So again, here's a little word of warning about when to use L'Hopital's rule and when not. Otherwise, you could end up getting something very incorrect out of there. Let's look maybe at one more problem here. I'm trying to find a more complicated one. So how about the limit as x goes to infinity? X divided by ln of 1 plus 2 times e to the x. Okay, so as x goes to infinity, the numerator is certainly going to infinity. E to the x will go to the infinity, will go to infinity as x goes to infinity. So the inside of the natural logarithm is going to infinity. And if you plug large numbers into the natural logarithm, you get large numbers out. So we are getting infinity over infinity. So I'm going to use L'Hopital's rule here. I'll have the limit as, again, x goes to infinity. The numerator is just 1. The denominator, again, if I take the derivative, I'll get 1 over 1 plus 2 e to the x. And then I have to multiply that by the derivative of the inside, which is just going to be 2 e to the x. And I'm going to clean this up before I do anything, before I start thinking about my limit. So the denominator, if you flip it and multiply, you'll have 1 plus 2 e to the x on top. And in the denominator, you'll have 2 e to the x. So again, as x goes to infinity, e to the x is infinity times 2 plus 1. You're still going to get infinity over infinity, which means we can use L'Hopital's rule again. So you can use L'Hopital's rule as many times as you want. Well, the derivative of 1 is 0. The derivative of 2e to the x is just 2e to the x. Same thing on the bottom. You know, again, you could think, well, this is still infinity over infinity, and if I keep doing L'Hopital's rule, I'm not going to get anywhere. But remember to simplify down algebraically. 2e to the x divided by 2e to the x is just going to equal 1, and the limit as x goes to infinity of 1 is simply 1. So that's going to be the answer in this case. Don't think I did anything weird on this problem. Check over everything. Think it looks okay to me here. So this is the basic idea. If you get 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity, just start taking the derivative of the top, the derivative of the bottom, simplify things down algebraically, and then just try to repeat the process. If you're still getting 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity, keep doing L'Hopital's rule again until you basically don't get that form anymore.